Spoken Realm Studios presents Tomcat Fury by Mike Guardia, narrated by Johnny Heller. Introduction. For more than three decades, the Grumman F-14 Tomcat was the U.S. Navy's premier carrier-based multirole fighter jet. From its harrowing combat missions over Libya to its appearance on the silver screen in movies like Top Gun and Executive Decision, the F-14 has become an icon of American air power. During its 32 years of naval service, the illustrious Tomcat garnered a reputation for its grit, glamour, and glory. Whether fulfilling the role of a high seas interceptor, ground attack aircraft, or an air superiority fighter, the F-14 was, without question, the U.S. Navy's jack of all trades, and a plane beloved by those who flew it. The F-14 began its journey into the annals of naval history in 1974, rolling off the assembly line at the Grumman Aerospace Facility in Calverton, New York. The Tomcat entered service as a replacement for the McDonnell Douglas F-4 Phantom. With its state-of-the-art swing-wing design, unmatched agility, and advanced avionics, the Tomcat seemed poised for a long and prosperous reign as the Navy's champion fighter jet. Aside from its operational versatility, the F-14 featured an advanced targeting system that could track up to 24 targets simultaneously and engage 6 of those targets at the same time. The Tomcat made its operational debut in the seas over South Vietnam. As the fledgling and beleaguered republic fell to the communists in April 1975, the F-14 Tomcat flew combat air patrols and provided aerial cover to the hellebore evacuations from Saigon. In 1976, the F-14 conducted its first intercept of a Tupolev Tu-95 Bear, the Soviet Navy's premier heavy bomber and reconnaissance aircraft. These intercepts became a recurring episode during the latter decades of the Cold War, ensuring that the Soviet bombers did not venture into American airspace or come within striking distance of the carrier groups at sea. American Tomcats first proved their mettle in combat over the Gulf of Sidra. In August 1981, during a routine combat air patrol off the northern coast of Libya, two F-14s from Squadron VF-41, Black Aces, were engaged by a pair of Sukhoi Su-22 fitters from the Libyan Air Force. Within minutes, however, both Tomcats had skillfully downed the Libyan bandits with a pair of AIM 9L Sidewinder missiles. The F-14 Tomcat continued its illustrious service into the 1980s, much of it during the bombing campaigns against Libya, but also during the contingency operations in Lebanon, Grenada, and the infamous Achille Lauro incident of 1985. Although the F-14 quickly rose to prominence as a symbol of American air power, it was the Islamic Republic of Iran who made the most extensive use of the F-14 in combat. Today, Iran is the only foreign operator of the F-14, and it remains the only country in the world with an active Tomcat fleet. Once America's strongest ally in the Middle East, Iran solicited weapons from the U.S., hoping to achieve parity with its neighbor, Iraq. Wanting to counter the Iraqis' latest generation MiGs, the Shah of Iran needed something of comparable or greater value. Having been a pilot himself, the Shah was dedicated to making the Iranian Air Force the strongest in the Middle East. Working with Grumman and the Pentagon, the Shah negotiated a $2 billion contract for 80 F-14s, along with a full stock of replacement parts and hundreds of newly built Phoenix missiles. This F-14 contract was, at the time, the highest value single sale of U.S. military equipment to a foreign power. Throughout its service in Iran's military, the F-14 garnered an impressive combat record during the Iran-Iraq War. The F-14 continued its remarkable run in U.S. service throughout the 1990s and well into the mid-2000s. During Operation Desert Storm, the U.S. Navy saw many of its F-14s relegated to supporting roles, primarily strike escort missions and reconnaissance flybys. It was during Desert Storm that the F-14 suffered its only loss in combat. This loss, however, was partially mitigated by the Tomcat becoming the first fighter in American history to shoot down an enemy helicopter. Following the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001, the F-14 Tomcat led some of the inaugural strikes against Al-Qaeda and the Taliban during the opening stages of Operation Enduring Freedom. The U.S. Navy retired the F-14 from active service in September 2006, its final combat mission having occurred 7 months earlier in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom. Despite the Tomcat's hard-earned reputation, acclaim, and ubiquity, however, there has never been a full combat history of the F-14.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.